We're not actors or TV personalities. We're just a couple of guys who want to show you how to restore your car. Sometimes we mess up. Sometimes we consult the pros. It's never a problem. It's always a project.
This week on Autorestomod, Jeff drives a Chevelle in for a bumper exchange. Bill helps with the cool tips, some extra hands, and a potentially deadly situation.
Baked beans.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend.
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
All right, this week on Autorestomod, we're going to show you how to add a little bling to your Chevy Chevelle. Now, the car overall looks pretty nice, but one of the problems we're running into is a lot of the chrome's getting kind of suspect. And while the car looks good, little details like that can make it better. So this week, Vinny and I are going to be working on...
Hey, tall guy, porn stash guy, he's not here today.
What do you mean he's not here?
Yeah, I was told to tell you he's not here.
Well, like, where is he? Is he at the hospital? I mean, is everything okay?
I don't know. Like I said the other day, I run the camera, I don't babysit.
Believe me, there are times that we need a babysitter.
Oy vey.
Okay. Give me... Taking vacations, not telling me anything about it. Paper. When you're... What are you doing here?
Just passing by. I figured you might need some help. I stopped in you and said, did you need some help? You need some
help? How do you pass by? We live on a cul-de-sac.
There's a street right out there. I'm in the car, you know. What are you doing? What are you doing anyway?
Have you ever put bumpers on a car before?
Sure. Nothing to it. Just take the bolts off, and take it off, and put the new one up there, and put the bolts back in.
Have you ever watched our show? Nothing goes on these cars like it's supposed to.
That's because I hadn't been around to help you. You ever thought about that?
All right, I'll take it.
Okay.
All right, Bill's gonna get the paper out of here since he wants to help. We're gonna have him help. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about what you need to do as soon as you get your parts in. Now, anytime you get parts in, like we've got our bumpers from the guys at National Parts Depot, what you need to do is pull the parts out and inspect them. And one of the things we recommend doing is inspecting them before you pull the parts off the car, particularly on a car like the Chevelle we've got back behind us. Now, the Chevelle is a driver that's a cruise night car, so you want to make sure that all the parts are there and clean and not damaged. And then when you make sure of that and make sure they all match what you've got here, then you can go ahead and start pulling all the old parts off the car to put the new parts on. Bumpers are a focal point on your car. And when you're doing this kind of stuff, you want to pay attention to that. Even on a driver car, a nice set of bumpers are going to set the car apart from other guys who didn't go out and spend the money. Even at a cruise night, you don't want stuff like where we've got some rust and all the scratches that are on the top of this bumper. Looks like it's been drug around in the dirt. Right here, this is kind of a problem on the Chevelles and even some of the Fairlane products. There's a water drip line right here, and the water will come off here and just beat on that bumper. And over time, it'll create a hole in the chrome, and then there will be a rust spot there like we've got right here on this bumper. When we're taking a bumper off of a car with good paint, what I like to use is this blue material I've got right here. Now this stuff is nice. It's got a kind of a plastic on the outside and a foam inside on it. So it's one of those kind of things where that's...
Where you get that?
Well, actually, I get this down at the Ford place.
Okay. Well, what do you do? Just walk in and say, give me a roll of that blue stuff?
Well, no. Actually, they'll pack their windshields and stuff like that in, and it's usually in the dumpsters.
Okay. The problem with that is everybody doesn't have access to the Ford dumpsters.
Okay. True.
Okay. The home improvement stores, every home improvement store has got this.
What is that?
Pipe insulation.
Okay, yeah.
Check this out, like that. Put a piece of tape on it.
Sold. How I dig that? It, Bill. That's awesome, man. I like that. All right, well, I'll tell you what. Let's get some tools and get this bumper off here, okay?
Cool.
All right. Now, we're going to be messing with the electrical system on the car, so one of the first things you want to do is disconnect the battery. What we'll say on this car that is kind of neat is the fact that this car actually has a cutoff switch for the battery system. So basically, you just flip that switch like you would on a race car, and this car is completely dead now. There's no electrical stuff running. So we don't actually have to disconnect the battery. Kind of like that. That's neat. Well, tool segment this week is short and sweet. One of the things you're going to be needing is a pair of locking pliers. Now, the locking pliers are going to give you everything you need as far as being able to grip onto the button head fasteners in case they decide to start spinning inside the hole, which does seem to happen a good bit. Another thing you're going to probably want to get your hands on is a really nice air or electric operated cutoff wheel. Now, this little item right here will save you a lot of grief trying to get those fasteners that won't come loose off the old bumper. The only other thing we'll say you're probably going to run into is you may need an 11/16 inch socket and an 11/16 inch end wrench. And the reason for that is this. Sometimes these fasteners are set up in a size like this, and it's a little unusual for some of the smaller kits to have an 11/16. So just keep that in the back of your mind. You may or may not need this.
This one bolt, they tried their best to hide it, but I found it. And also, I've already went in and more or less broke them loose, so it take out one of the variables of having a problem taking everything loose.
I think yours is shorter.
No, I just work faster.
We're gonna leave the bolts in here until we get all the nuts off, take the nuts off, then we're gonna go in and actually take the back bolt out first and take the front bolt out. This is why it's a job for two people, in my opinion. I wouldn't want to try to do this with just one guy, because one person on this trying to get both of these undone, you're definitely going to take a good risk of damaging your paint by doing it that way. All right, you ready? I'm going to support it. I got my bolt out. Getting too old for this.
All right, there we go. It's loose. The reason that we took it loose here instead of taking the bolts out are because they're the rust. If you see this bolt, you can get a loose fairly well, and the other one also, but the top bolts, which is the hardest to get to anyway, are square bolts, and they are a pain, I won't say where, to get out. But once you get it out on the floor, on the workbench, it's a piece of cake compared to in the still on the car.
All right, now we've talked to you about problems with nicking the paint with the bumper being installed without doing some kind of protection on the bumper for the car. Now, you'll see right here on the paint, there's a little nick in the point of it. That wasn't there from us. This has been here a while, because you see a little spot of rust in the center of it. So whenever they put the bumper on originally, they probably nicked the paint with the bumper on the install. Once again, another good reason to protect your bumper and your paint using some kind of stuff like the pipe wrap that Bill brought up earlier.
One of the bad things that you run into on 9 out of 10 older vehicles that has been worked on, messed with, or modified, every bolt in this bumper is a different size. I mean, there's no two bolts the same size. Hopefully, the vice grips will hold this back side on this one. Yeehaw! How about that? This is the other problem you run into. This is the wrong bolt. It's way too small for the square hole now to get the other one.
And sometimes you just have to resort to a cutoff wheel to get the old bolts off of the bumper so you can reuse the brackets. Now I want to show you a little something on this bumper which makes it pretty much unusable for anything. And yes, I know I have my sexy glasses on. That shouldn't happen on a bumper. The chrome on this is basically broken through on the backside. Bumper shops can repair something like this, but when you can pick up a bumper as cheaply as you can from National Parts Depot, I don't see any point in going in and laboring over this bumper when there's a reproduction available. One of the things that we probably should have done, had this car been one that we were doing as a full-on restoration, was to replace the bumper brackets. Now, we're going to reuse them on this car. They're a little tatty, but looking at the underside of the car, we're not that worried about it. Neither is the owner. This is a car that he's going to be driving every day. Well, maybe not every day, but occasionally. What we're going to do now is we're going to take the marker lights, drill those out, take them off, and show you how to do a quick repair to these kind of marker lights if the guy's done what they've done on this with the Stakon connectors. So we're going to go in, show you how to fix that up and make it work well enough. All right, we caught a lucky break on the car, and that was this. The owner saw these bumper brackets we've got here and quite frankly was not impressed. He wanted to replace them because he has a couple of Chevelles laying around the shop. So he brought us some new bumper brackets and we've already got them painted up and put on one side of here. We're going to show you how to install the others in just a second. And what we're going to be using for that is bumper bolts that we got from the guys at National Parts Depot. Now these bolts are a nice kit, ready to rock and roll. Now, and then one thing that we did do is we went in and bought some stainless fasteners for the bottom of the bumper because we wanted those fasteners to be nice all the time. Oh man.
Right. How's that?
These look great, Bill. Yeah. Now, what all did you do here?
Well, I just took them back over to my shop there and I got the broke off screws out of it, drilled them out the next size, tapped them, sprayed them with rust inhibited black. The thing about it, the way this bumper is put together, you've got plenty enough room on the top side to put nuts if you don't have the equipment to retap them.
Because you just basically retap these, brought
right.
some stainless steel fasteners
right.
in again, keep things from rusting.
Yeah, got the stainless steel fasteners there. That's it.
Cool.
You're ready to go.
Awesome. All right, before Bill took off with the marker lights, what I did was I actually went in and rewired this setup so that we could use it the way it is. Rather than going in and spending a ton of money buying a set of marker lights, we went down to the Home Improvement Center and picked up some extension leads from their trailer department so that we can actually go in and wire this up. Basically, these things are available pretty much anywhere. So if you wanted to do this kind of a setup on yours, you can. These are not factory hookups. These are actually kind of a Band-Aid, but it's a nice Band-Aid. It's one that'll work really well on the car. So what I did was this. I took these and actually went in and covered the white wire with some black shrink wrap so that we've got the effect of a black wire for our ground. That way we know, or anybody that picks up this car knows, that this is the ground wire coming off the marker lights. The red wires are hot wire, so we know that that's good to go. Now inside the engine bay, we did the same thing. We basically took the other half of the plug, put a black shrink wrap on it, put the wires connected correctly off of what we had with the Stakons that were on there before, and we should be good to go. Now all I gotta do is get up underneath here and put these on before we put the bumper on so that the marker lights are just hanging there and not in the way. Now there's probably a couple of different ways you can do this, but just from my point of view, it's a little easier to set it up underneath here with these just hanging down inside of here and just getting them from underneath.
Oh, this is much prettier. What I like to point out right here is when you're putting something like this back together, never strong arm tighten it, just hand tighten it. That way, if you need to move it around, you've got some movement to work with. Okay, well, we're ready for the foam to go across the top and put it back. Jeffrey, where the foam?
Bill, what did you have for lunch?
Baked beans, potato salad, roast chicken.
I think I got something else I'm gonna do right now. Ready, Bill?
I'm ready.
Let's do it.
How are we gonna do this?
Let's just lay down flat. Sit it on your chest.
Oh yeah. Oh yes.
You hear that crunching whenever we put it through there? back one in. Front one in. The front one's real easy to get to. The back one is not. Okay, so we've determined that doing it this way is easier if you come from the inside out with the bolt. All right, now what we've got here is the bumper sitting down below the stone guard when we install it, and that's not really a problem. What we need to do now is keep our bolts on the brackets loose and then pull the bumper forward and up and over the stone guard. And that's where this foam will be kind of nice, because it'll actually keep separation between the stone guard and the bumper and give us probably a pretty decent spacing overall. We may be able to just tighten it right up using the foam as our spacer. Ready, Bill?
Yeah.
Okay. Are we over the top of it?
Huh?
Are we over the top of it?
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Probably a little too high at this
yeah.
point. Now, you're gonna have a little bit of back and forth on this. You'll set this in here, check your positions, and then start monkeying around with the height of the bumper and how it sits in here before you finish anything else up.
Yeah.
All right, now I'm gonna take and do a visual check of the bumper to see how it sits. Okay, we're a little high, probably on my side. All right, now what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna take our foam off the bumper so we can start eyeballing it on the outside edges. And we're not gonna take it all the way off. I'm just gonna take it off to the edge of the fender here so that we still got it wrapped around this outside edge so we don't damage that while we're working. All right, now after we get that side off there, what we'll do is we'll start eyeballing the bumper. Now we're a little low compared to my side on Bill's.
Right.
So if he's not too tight, he might be able to pull his
up. Be too tight.
We're a little high at the center, Bill. This is why you don't want to get it really, really tight. You want to just snug it up so that you can go in and make these kind of minute adjustments on it. Oops.
Ooh.
We dropped a lot. You'll also want to go in after you get everything pretty much set and check distance using your fingers to make sure that you got a fairly equal distance across the bumper. That looks about right. Okay.
And my side is.
Your side's a little bit high. Okay, now what we're doing is we're going in and going from side to side, checking fit to make sure the bumper's the way we want it. Now what I've got Bill doing right now is I'm holding the bumper in the position I like, and he's gonna go in and tighten the bolts up on this side of the car.
Okay.
All right, got both of them tight?
Yeah.
All right, now I'll go out, step back from it, take a look at the bumper, make sure I'm happy with the position and fit. It's pretty even on both sides. Now we're gonna go ahead and pull our foam off of here and completely and see what we got. Hopefully we're happy with it. If not, we can always put the foam back on the center section to make more adjustments. But for right now, I'm looking at it and pretty pleased with what I see. So Bill?
Yo.
I hate to say this.
What?
But it's actually been really fun working with you today.
Cool. We'll do it again sometime.
Yeah, just as long as you don't have beans for lunch.
Well, I don't have beans for lunch. Well, let's see, what can I have for lunch? Tacos?
No, that's
burritos.
Not good.
Yeah,
that's not good.
I love burritos.
No. All right, folks, that's our show for this week. Next, we're going to be coming back to you with how to install the fold-down system on a 1967 Mustang Fastback. We're jumping on the 67 because Vinny's out of town and he can't defend himself with the 65, so we go back to the 67. So do us a favor and watch us then on Autorestomod. All right, Bill, let's go get something to drink. Oh, yeah, you probably want to see what it looks like done, huh? Well, here you go.